G'day, it's Troy Cassar-Daley here. Welcome to the special acoustic performance of 50 songs in 50 towns. Really, really excited to have these songs put out for you, and I can't wait to take you on the journey of these tunes. As you can see, I've got an old bit of my familiar life behind me here. There's my number one guitar and my old EH Holden. And it's going to be really important for me, I suppose, to have a few of these really special things in the gig tonight, because I've also got some very special family and friends coming along to this show. Launching a record like this is something I've wanted to do for a long, long time. Live acoustic versions of these tunes is something that I've done all my life, and I'm really, really looking forward to being able to make sure that we share them with you. Have a look at the car. It'll look a lot better than me, that's for sure. It's a lot shinier. I really hope you enjoy it. There's a lot of miles in these songs, and I really hope you leave every one of them with me.
Troy Cassar-Daley.
Now, just some of the things that carry around.
My most enjoyable part of being on the road is the minute before I step on stage. It's just an escape. The last few shows we've done have been just like 2 hours of absolute bliss and make me smile. And it's also wonderful to see the smiles that come the other way from the audience as well.
I've been driving every back road in this old car. One headlight working, and it's only overheated 3 times so far. I guess that's pretty good. The truth is, I can't remember when. But tonight, I won't lie, I'm hurting. I'm thinking about drinking again.
Being an older artist now, I've toured with a lot of people. We did a tour with Midnight Oil, we've been on the road with Cold Chisel, and it's been amazing to be able to see those acts in full swing. But to take your daughter out on her gap year when she was deciding whether she needed to go to university or maybe hang with an old burnt out country music dad and come on the road, it was great to have her out. What I became was one of the most excited tour guides that you could possibly imagine. Every town we got up, we walked every morning and took that town in and carried it in our hearts. And I think that's the secret to touring, and I hope Jem felt a little bit of that love that we have for a lot of the towns we went through. 50 songs in 50 towns is a lot to cover, but if you've got a long drive, Jem and I did many of them making this record, get in the car and take it and take these songs with you.
Well, we've got a special guest. Now, this young special guest I took out on the road with me in 2019. And she didn't know whether she wanted to be going to university or going out on the road with her old dad. So please make welcome Miss Jem Cassar-Daley. This is probably one of the last country gigs you'll see her at. It's just nice to be able to remember what we did in 2019 on the road.
Yeah.
We did about 70 odd shows, so it was really easy to find 50 songs in 50 towns. And she loves old bluegrass music as much as she loves what she plays. So we thought we'd give this little one a go. Now, Michael Fix, I've got to say to Michael Fix, there is a capo change here like George Jones, so be aware. It looks very sketchy. Anyway. All right.
Is that the right key?
I hope so. She used to ask that every night on the road too. Have you got the right key?
Because once you start, it's too far.
I know. Once you've committed, that's it. Anyway, it's an old Louvin Brothers song, and they've got some very, very sad old material, but this is just one of them. And this is one of the ones on the record as well. So please thank Jem for coming in and sharing it with me.
Thank you.
I've had nothing but sorrow since you said we were through. There's no hope for tomorrow. How's the world treating you?
Being a proud Goombanga man, it's always been a part of my life to paint. My mum taught me to paint when I was very, very little. I've got some pictures at home with my handprint when I was a tiny child that mum would sit down and show me how to paint. So everywhere I go on the adventure of playing country music was always looking out over a river or looking out over some mountain range somewhere across this incredible country. And it was always inspiring for me to actually take a little bit of that in with me and draw it on the plane. So I'd do a sketch and then I'd take it home and finish it off. Some of them were about, you know, some of the places we got to see and play gigs at, but other ones were simply just the places where you look out the window and it just took me. And rivers in particular, we have quite a few different paintings with rivers in them as well. They're one thing that do grab me. It's not only really special to share the songs from 50 Songs, 50 Towns, but to have art associated with the places that we got to visit is really, really important. It's a big part of my world. And only recently losing my mum, it's made me probably more inspired to actually continue to paint the older that I get.
A boat back up the river, back to my old fishing place. I'm afraid this old river's gonna overflow from the tears running down my face. Nothing but a river boy, ain't good for nothing, river boy. This old world don't hold a whole lot of joy when you're nothing but a river boy. One more. This old world don't hold a whole lot of joy when you're nothing but a river boy.
Yoo-hoo! You're making me weak. That is just gorgeous.
I want to say
rallies, and they were all big old Christian get-togethers, and they had them in these tents. And we got up there and listened to some of the most amazing singing. We always came back feeling really lifted and really inspired to play. And I think Brucey Walker was one of them, old fellas, and all those old men. But this song always reminds me, when Don and I wrote this song, it took me straight back to that little tent. I was standing at the end of every wicked way I knew, in a place so bad I couldn't see. And I broke down and cried, saying, what else can I? And I'm a walking down the road he made for me, down the road he made for me, where the sun.
There are so many towns that we had to cover. That's why we had to make 50 songs in 50 towns. One of the most important little gigs I think that we did when Jem and I were on the road together in 2019 was a place called Coots Crossing. There's a lady there called Teddy Bowles who has booked me for gigs for her birthday parties and different things like that when I was actually very young. So to come back and do a show with my daughter, who was about 18 or 19 at the time, is really a full circle event. So all hail to Coots Crossing and the people that filled that tiny, tiny hall. It was one of the highlights of the tour for me.
I've made a promise to Tamworth and Grafton to donate some golden guitars to give them for wherever there's a lot of thoroughfare so people can walk past and see them, because I was sitting in my studio the other day with them on the bench behind me and I thought, what a waste, you know? Why should people not be able to see these things? So I'm going to line it up with them. But the only one that I'm keeping is Shadows on the Hill. It's for my cousin. And it's got a long story, but I'm not going to tell it tonight because I'll get too upset. Can't do it. It's better that I just sing it. It's a song of truth. And the more truth we tell in this country, the closer we'll become. And it's going to be an exciting time when the truth really does come out. This song is it's been a best friend. Got me through some really terrible times. I see shadows on the hill up beside the old sawmill where my people were killed. I see shadows on the hill. I see shadows on the ground where the bones don't make no sound.
Knowing that your songs connect with people is something else. We've met a lot of people at VIP events where they ask you about a particular song, what it was written about, and how it affected their life. I think that's some of the highlighted parts of my life and my career, when people actually say, this is how it affected me. It's a wonderful thing as a songwriter to get that acknowledgement, and it's also a wonderful thing as an entertainer.
Look, so I'd like to do a song called Born to Survive, because every time we play it at night on the Ian run, it always digs something up out of me, especially with storytelling. And it was, you know, a father and a son talking about the drought, and we were sitting on the front step at Wee War at the service station, the worst coffee I've ever had in my life. And I thought, you know, there's got to be a payoff here somewhere. Well, there was, because the father and son pulled up a stump next to me while the father was rolling an old tally-ho, and he was just talking about the last 6 months they'd had on the Laird property, you know. And I thought, wow. And I'd only just gotten a loan of a harmonica from Paul, and Paul said, take it with you. I said, it's got spit in it, mate. He said, yeah, it's magic spit. Anyway, it is. It was magic, because this song bloody fell out of that same harmonica that he gave me. And it's called Born to Survive. And thanks again for coming in. I'm going to be over here with Simon and saying g'day. So please come and say hi and let me thank you personally.
We were born to survive our bad life, generations of toil and strife. We don't know any other way, no, no. When the sun beats down so damn hard, 40 degrees in the holy yard, got a 303 and a four-wheel drive, living at here we're born to survive. Born to survive, yeah. Yes, we are. Yes, we are.
Thank you very, very much, Brisbane. We love you. Come on over and say g'day. I'll have a quick drink and I'll be right over there to say hello out the front of Daphne. Thanks again for your time. Thanks for listening to my songs, and you've been a beautiful crowd. Thank you.